Hello everybody, welcome to our channel Docket Babies. I am Dr. Nupur Ghosh. Today I'm going to talk about a very important topic, which is fever in babies. So fever, parents, is generally something, you know, it frequently comes, but we as a parent, you know, we panic a lot, and I am among one of those moms who panics a lot when my baby has got fever. Touch of Jashvi doesn't get so much of that, but recently, as I had shared with you, she had a pretty high fever and I was very terrified. So what I learned from that and what I read about the fever, everything, I just want to share my experience, and I'm going to tell you about few things. The first one being, when do we consider fever in babies? That what is the temperature when we consider that, okay, the baby has got fever. Number two, I'm going to discuss some of the symptoms. Number three, I'm going to tell you when to take your baby to the doctor when he has got fever. And number four, that is the treatment options, some home remedies and some medicines. So what's the wait? Let's start our video.
To be the first one to watch all our videos, click on the subscribe button. And for regular updates, please hit the bell icon. Welcome to Docket Babies.
Before starting our video, there is a request. If you like our video, please do click on the like button below. It will just take a second for you. And do subscribe to our channel Docket Babies. It encourages a lot both me and Sunira to bring more informative videos for you, to bring more recipes and more vlogs of Jashvi and Inaya. You can also follow us on our Facebook page and Instagram page. Just type Docket Babies and we are there. Okay, so let's get started. The first of all is, when do we consider fever in babies? See, generally a temperature of 97 degree Fahrenheit, 200.3 degree Fahrenheit is considered normal in babies. It is absolutely normal, 100.3 is normal. But if your baby has got a temperature of 100.4, the rectal temperature of 100.4 or higher, then that is called a fever. So you have to keep that in mind, that 100.4, that number you have to keep in mind. So if that temperature is there or more, then obviously your baby has got fever. So that's the answer to first question, that when the babies are considered to have fever. Let's talk about the second thing. I was talking about the symptoms of fever or the seriousness of fever. See, talking about the symptoms or the seriousness, when it basically depends upon the age. When your baby is less than 3 months or 3 months of age, if you see a temperature of 100.4, immediately go to the doctor. That's what my advice is. Immediately go to the doctor, because this smaller baby, you know, anything can happen. I mean, the baby is very small. He can have some serious infections. So you should not wait for any home remedies or any kind of home treatments. You should immediately rush to the doctor. Now let's talk about little bigger babies, that is more than 3 months of babies. So for more than 3 months, if you see the temperatures around 100.4 or 100.5, you can wait up to 24 hours. But again, if the temperature is higher, say about more than 101, you have to go to the doctor immediately. If the temperature is 100.4 or somewhere around that, and you see that the baby is normal, I mean, he's taking the diet, he's taking food normally, he's playing normally, just enjoying his life, you don't see anything change in him, so then you can just wait for some time. You can wait for at least 24 hours, that is a day, before consulting a doctor. Again, to add on this, if your baby shows some more symptoms with fever, that is fever plus he shows vomitings, he shows cough and cold, the baby is becoming very pale, he is becoming very flushed, then you have to rush to the doctor immediately. If you see that the wet diapers, the pee and poop, they are less than normal, then also it's time to go to the doctor. Then there is something called an unexplained rash. And unexplained rash, you know, a purple or reddish color, you see it somewhere on the body, then that's a very serious thing. You know, then immediately you should consult a doctor about it, because something more serious infection can happen with that. So that unexplained rash also calls to see the doctor immediately. If there is breathlessness, that is your child is having difficulty in breathing, he may be having bronchitis or he may be having pneumonia. So then also you should consult the doctor immediately. So that was all about when to consult the doctor. So if your baby is obviously 3 months or less, immediately go to the doctor. If it is 100.4 or 100.5, doesn't matter. But if he's more than 3 months, you can wait up to 24 hours if the fever is not increasing, if the child is entirely normal, not accompanied with any other symptoms. So I hope you have understood this, that when to call a doctor. Now straight away, let's go to the important part, that is the treatment. So if you are at home and the temperature is not too high, and if you're at home, what can you do to bring your child at ease? So the first of all is you have to keep in mind that the child is properly hydrated, you know, because this dehydration problem that happens so normally when the baby has got fever. So what can you do about it is, if your baby is about 6 months or younger than that, you have to constantly feed him breast milk and formula, and the breast milk plays miracles in this. That's my personal experience. Jashvi, whenever she had fever, I used to just offer her breast milk as many times as I could, and she used to get very normalized after drinking that. If your baby is more than 6 months, then you can have plenty of options apart from water, breast milk, formula, or if your baby is more than a year, you can offer cow milk as well. You can give him variety of soups, some hot soups. Like if you're a non-vegetarian, you can offer him chicken soup. That's also very beneficial. If you're a vegetarian, then you can give palak soups, then spinach soup, broccoli, carrots, and so many things. So all these things, you know, they boost the immune system, they give them strength, and also keeps them hydrated. Okay, now let's talk about the next thing. You have to give them plenty of rest. You know, the babies, they have that habit of just running around. Especially I've seen with Jashvi, it's so very difficult to keep her at one place. So when she had fever, you know, I used to put on the TV. I know that TV is not good, but at that point I felt that it's more important that she rests at bed rather than just thinking that TV is not good. So I used to put the TV on, put some cartoon on that, or put some nursery rhymes, and let her watch. At least she was on bed for some time, because otherwise it's so very tough to stop her. Because rest is very important, you know, that can just bring down the temperature. Apart from that, I want to talk about the dressing here. I have seen parents, you know, whenever the baby has got a fever, they overdress, they bundle him around, you know, full one layer, two layer, three layer. Don't do that. Don't do that. It's not required. You should actually dress your babies in cotton clothes, loose cotton clothes, so that he is at ease and he properly gets that rest. Even when he's sleeping, don't overdress him so that he sweats a lot and just gets up and doesn't get that proper sleep. So you just keep in mind that. But if at all the baby's feeling some chills and all, just give him a thin blanket so that he feels normal. Next thing is, see, during fevers, even we as adults, we don't feel like eating anything. And same happens with the babies too. So don't ever force the baby to eat. If the baby is taking fluids, that's okay, you know. It's fine. It's not important to eat. So keep that in mind. The baby is not feeling well, and if you force, nothing will happen. He's just going to vomit. So don't force to eat. The room temperature has to be moderate. You should try keeping the room temperature between 70 degree Fahrenheit to 74 degree Fahrenheit. That's what you should try to maintain. Next thing about sponging. A very important thing here is that you should always sponge your baby with lukewarm water. Never sponge your baby with cold water or alcohol, by rubbing alcohol. Even I've seen some places. So never do that. You know, alcohol is very dangerous. It can just bring down the body temperature immediately down, and it's kind of very dangerous for the babies. And even you should never use cold water. You should always use lukewarm water. Take a clean sponge or a cotton cloth and you can sponge with that. Or you can even try giving a lukewarm water bath to babies, a small wash. Obviously, don't dampen the hair, just wash the body, and that's also quite beneficial. Last but not the least, let's talk about the medicines. Before telling you about the medicines, always and always consult a doctor before giving any medicine to babies. Don't try out your own mind. Don't try out your relative's mind, don't try out your friend's mind. You should only and only trust the doctor here with the babies. Please, any kind of medicines you're giving, any medicines, say paracetamol also, always consult your doctor, the baby's doctor. Okay, So see, the medicine actually, you know, it depends upon the age and weight of the baby. So doctor actually, he considers the age plus he calculates the weight. So there is some calculation and then accordingly he prescribes how much amount is to be given to the babies. So we all know that for fever, this infant acetaminophen, that is paracetamol, infant paracetamol comes, and that is generally given. He gives you the dose, whatever is required, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, whatever is required. And you should never exceed the limit because it can be very dangerous. Also, an important point here that aspirin, you should never, you should never give your child up to the age of at least 18 years. Don't give your child aspirin. You know, aspirin makes the baby's body more susceptible to Reye syndrome and it is life-threatening. It is very serious, fatal condition. So never up to the age of 18 years give your baby aspirin, no aspirin, please remember that. So that's the reason I'm telling you, always consult your baby's doctor before giving any medicine. So that was it about the fever. See, don't panic too much, although I am among those mothers, but I have also learned from time to time that do not panic. Fever is just a defense mechanism of the body. It's just way a body is fighting out against infections. Basically, you know, when the body raises temperature, it brings, tries to bring in more white blood cells, tries to bring in more antibodies so that it can fight out the infection. So just a defense mechanism. Try out some of these home remedies, and try, if at all I have told you when to rush to a doctor, just go to a doctor, the doctor will give the medicines and the child will be fine and you will be happier as well. So that was it. Just take care of you and your baby. Enjoy these changing weathers, but these changing weathers are more prone to infections, so take care about that. I hope you liked our video. Please do click on the like button. We'll just take a second, and do subscribe to Doc and Babies. Take care. Happy parenting.